your home for the NHL.
The St. Pete Times Forum in Tampa, Florida. The site of a marquee matchup between two prime examples of promise fulfilled. Steven Stamkos, the leading goal scorer last year with 51 goals for the Lightning. And Sidney Crosby, the leading goal scorer in the NHL last year with 51 goals for the Pittsburgh Penguins. They'll lead their respective teams tonight in a game that will decide the top spot in the Eastern Conference standings. Hello again, everybody.
Well, the Penguins will try and wrap up this week-long three-city trip with a victory tonight against the Tampa Bay Lightning here on FSN. And Paul, I would think one of the things that are high on your list of things to do tonight would be to slow down Steven Stamkos. So without him hearing, how are you going to do it?
Well, it's tough. You know, those type of caliber players are going to get their opportunities. They're just trying to minimize their opportunities and take away their time and space. They have some other talented guys there too, but it's a team effort. Everyone needs to be aware of where they are at all times.
Their offense as a whole, according to head coach Dan Bylsma, like to get a lot of pucks to the blue paint, kind of create a lot of traffic. How do you disrupt that?
It's tough. I mean, hopefully it will be, it's our job to get it in their end, you know, behind their D, and hopefully wear them out down that way as opposed to being in our end more and giving them that much more time to make plays.
Hitting here. Good luck tonight.
All right, thanks.
Guys, it's all yours.
All right, thank you, Dan. Let's take a look at our Toyota lineup here tonight, Bob.
Well, it's the same. Crosby, mainstay Kunitz on the left, Pascal Dupuis on the right, Mark Letestu, centers Malkin on the right, and Comrie on the left, Max Talbot, Tyler Kennedy, and the NHL's leading hitter, Matt Cook on the left, Craig Adams, he'll center Aaron Asham and Mike Rupp. And the defensive pairings look like this for Dan Bylsma here tonight in Tampa. Brooks Orpik and Ben Lovejoy, Paul Martin, Chris Letang, second in D scoring, and Alex Goligoski and Derek Englund.
And Marc-Andre Fleury will be in goal, only his second start in the last 13 days. It's the Penguins and Bolts coming up.
I think it was just a wonderful thing that Jackie came along. Then we had somebody to look up to.
Jackie Robinson was indeed a catalyst for change in baseball and the spark to help America change as well.
That was the beginning of the Civil Rights Movement. That was before Brown versus the Board of Education. That was before Sister Rosa Parks saying, "I'm not going to move in the back of the bus today." Yeah, that started the ball rolling.
Jackie Robinson did more for integration than maybe Martin Luther King did. He was, to me, one of the great social pioneers in this nation's history.
I can only quote what he said himself. He said, "A life is not important except in its impact on the lives of others." Everything he did and thought about, all of his dreams, all of the concerns, had to do with our race and the advancement of our race.
I'm J.W. Stewart. Coming up tonight on Sports Center on ESPN America, Game 1 of the World Series in San Francisco, where Tim Lincecum and the Giants were hosting Cliff Lee of the Rangers. This one far from a pitcher's duel. All the highlights and reaction on the big show. Plus, LeBron and the Heat looking for their first win in Philly, and LeBron's old team looking to do what the Heat could not, beat the Celtics. All this and more tonight on Sports Center on ESPN America.
Here we go, Jody Schoeling.
And Mike Rupp.
Fires a shot, didn't go in, but the rebound did.
Here's Dumont, shoots and scores.
Now Zhirdev, he's going to come to the goal, great save.
He's on his own, scores! Captain Giunta with his first of the season.
In front, wide open, and Erickson, top corner.
Kovalchuk, he dangles, oh, Thomas robs Kovalchuk.
And to save the shot, he scores! He blew it by Bobrovsky that time.
Ribeiro! Oh! Unbelievable save by Coughlin.
Turns it back to Ryder, the shot, scores! Oh, Tyler Seguin, how fast is he?
You are the tease master.
Cronwall scores! Red Wings win in overtime.
Erickson left it, and he scored!
Right to Kunitz, closing in to the goal, he scores!
And Ovechkin, a big pass to win it for the Washington Capitals. He's done it again.
NHL is on ESPN America. Catch every team, every goal, and all the big games, including the playoffs and the Stanley Cup Finals. Plus, NHL on the Fly keeps you in the know. Looking for NHL action? The puck stops here. Hockey's best go head-to-head all season long, live on ESPN America, home of the NHL.
Yes, the flower is in the net tonight for the Penguins. Bob, he's our Kia starting goaltender for the Pens.
Well, he is. This is only his second start in the last 13 days. He's got 149 wins, looking to become the seventh youngest goaltender to reach that 150-win plateau. Is Marc-Andre Fleury going against this man, Mike Smith, 6'4". Mike Smith, 4-0 on the season. His last shutout was against the Pittsburgh Penguins, our Hyundai starting goaltender.
Penguins start an interesting line. They've got Crosby in the middle between Mike Rupp and Aaron Asham. So Aaron Asham starting his first game as a Penguin tonight. Brooks Orpik and Chris Letang on defense. The grind line for the Tampa Bay Lightning. An energy line on the ice right now with Nate Thompson, Adam Hall, the former Penguin, and Dana Terrell on the ice. Up front, and the shot by Orpik is stopped by Smith. The rebound, pushed just wide of the goal by Sidney Crosby. Rupp in on Hedman, who was able to work the puck up the near boards and out to center. Well, a great opportunity right off the hop as the Penguins go with a couple of grinders on either side of Sidney Crosby.
Yeah, so you could have called, when you said grind line, but maybe you were referring to the Pittsburgh Penguins with Crosby, because he can grind them out with the best of them if you want to play that game.
Pavel Kubina on defense now to Marty St. Louis, and up the wall now for Steven Stamkos, who wears 91 because he was a big fan of Steve Yzerman and Joe Sakic, who wore 19. He wheels the puck towards the net off the stick of St. Louis. And those two are like bread and butter. They really know where each other are all the time on the ice. It's sort of the way St. Louis and Le Cavalier had it going a couple of years ago. Shot from the point attempted by Randy Jones is off a stick to the corner. Steve Downey tried to play it, but St. Louis ends up with it. Sends it up the wall looking for Kubina. Matt Cook got in the way of that. And now Derek Engelin able to just push the puck to open ice and up into the Tampa Bay zone.
A good forecheck by the Penguins, who really got their feet moving here after a couple days off here in sunny Florida.
And now here's Paul Martin, and they had a chance to work on this ice surface too for a couple of days of practice. So they've gotten accustomed to their surroundings. Back for the puck now goes Paul Martin, swinging away from Vincent Lecavalier. Moves it rink wide for Matt Cook. And Cook feeds it right into the middle. The shot by Lovejoy was blocked. He'll come after the puck again and backhand it in deep. Hedman takes a solid body check that time from Mark Letestu. And Tyler Kennedy on the ice moves it back to Paul Martin. He's on his backhand. Kennedy sent it to the corner. Hedman is there. Penguins break it up, though. Good forecheck here. Comrie is flattened, though. Plastered by Matthias Olin, playing his first game of the season. He's been out with a knee injury. Now Alex Goligoski goes to the right side. Engelin with a wrister, and it's blocked in front. It hit Olin. He wasn't even looking, and now he's feeling that shot off the right boot as he heads over to the bench. Engelin fights his way back to the puck nicely for the Penguins, and they quickly start out of their own zone. Goligoski to Letestu, and he looks for Malkin, but instead tries to get it to the net. Alex Goligoski moves in deep to take the puck. He's kind of backing up towards his defensive position as he works it back around to the other side. Adam Hall is there. He overskates, and Letestu able to get to the puck. Now taken by number 21, Matias Rotola, former Red Wing, who was acquired on waivers by the Lightning from Detroit. Good place to go for players if you're looking for good ones that can play. The Detroit Red Wings, and Steve Yzerman familiar with their personnel, of course, the general manager of the Lightning.
Yeah, he picked up the Penguin, ex-Penguin Adam Hall, who played against his Red Wings.
Good chance, they score on the first shot of the hockey game. It is Dana Terrell getting his first NHL point, his first NHL goal to give the Lightning a 1-0 lead.
Well, this all started on a Penguin change. The puck went down the wall. When the Penguins came off the ice, Chris Letang and company, they didn't play it. The puck comes back in. Marc-Andre Fleury, he can't handle that end around, and they win a battle. Thompson out in front of the net to number 42, Dana Tyrell. Thompson to Tyrell. And you called it, Stege. That happened that quickly at the heart around. Marc-Andre Fleury unable to stop that. A battle is won by Tampa behind the net. And as Fleury's looking over his right shoulder, that puck somehow finds its way between his right pad and the goalpost. It's 1-0 Tampa on the first shot. And Marc-Andre Fleury let in his first shot, you remember, in Nashville. And then he came on strong.
What's weird is that the Lightning got a goal similar to that from Adam Hall against Nashville the other night, coming out from behind the net. And Dan Bylsma said today, they generate offense around the net, coming out from behind the goal. It's exactly what they did there. So the Penguins knew that they do it, but they weren't quite ready to stop it tonight as Dana Terrell gets the goal. Now we get a whistle and a penalty coming up. It's going to be a holding call. And it's going to be against the Penguins.
Pittsburgh minor penalty number 9, holding.
That's three consecutive games in which Pascal Dupuy has taken a penalty. He's not really a guy who does a lot of that. He usually keeps his feet moving.
Well, his feet were so fast there. It was one hand against Dana Terrell, the goal scorer, who stayed on the ice for Tampa. Now that potent power play comes on. And you look at the talent on this power play, and you just have to think about denying one person, I think. Let the other guys beat you. I know that doesn't sound quite right. Here's a two-on-one.
Matt Cook with it. He's got a man open right side. It's Adam shooting, scoring! Beautiful shot. He rifled it into the net, too. Craig Adams gets his first regular season goal in a long, long time.
Well, I got to stop talking, and I did, because I saw the Penguins go down 2-on-1 shorthanded, and you knew for Mr. Adams, who didn't score last year, gets his first this year. That's his first goal in 119 games. You're going to go back to December 16th, 2008, to find the last time in the regular season that Craig Adams has lit the lamp. So the Penguins score on their second shot. The Lightning score on their first. And we have a barn burner here in Tampa Bay.
Well, that's a great way to answer a first goal and a first shot. It's come right back with a shorthanded goal. Take a little starch out of that Tampa Bay power play that's ranked fourth in the NHL. 10 for 38 coming in. And an offside call against the Lightning as they enter the Penguins zone. Take another look at the goal scored by Dana Tyrell, his first NHL goal.
No, we're going to look at the Penguin goal. How about this?
Oh, okay.
His first NHL goal this year.
I'm sorry. Yep. Adams.
And Craig Adams. And for Craig Adams, he was the last draft pick for the Hartford Whalers. And I bet you that goal felt like he hadn't scored since he was a member of the Whale, because it's a long time between goals. And, you know, he comes up big in the playoffs. He's a mean son of a gun, Craig Adams is. And he's got to feel good to get that one off his back.
Goals from guys like that mean more than just the goal that's up on the board. There's a whole deeper meaning to it when a guy like Craig Adams gets you a goal. Players are pulling for him. They want him to score.
It's certainly unexpected. You would have to say that, and that's no disrespect to Craig Adams, but agree. And a shorthanded one to boot when the Lightning had a chance to go up 2-0 with their power play.
Now Downey in after the puck for the Lightning. Another opportunity for the Penguins shorthanded. Letang to the goal. He shoots. Great save. Rebound. Puck scores on the rebound. And the Penguins get a pair of shorties on the same power play. And it is a 2-1 Pittsburgh lead.
And Pascal Dupuy is going to be taking credit for all this. He's standing up in the penalty box, slamming on the door, saying, keep me in. Keep me in. What a great play again by Matt Cook. Adams comes over for support. Watch the dish pass. Look at that. To a defenseman joining the rush shorthanded. And Cook tapped it in right under the crossbar. He had a wide open net. But what the heck? That's too easy. I'm going to put it in up under the crossbar. And the Penguins get two shorties. Chris Letang now is atop the heap of NHL scoring defensemen with 9. He's tied with John Michael Lyles. But you can put Letang's name up there ahead because he's got 2 goals to Lyles' none.
And Smith had no clue where the puck was after he made the save, and because he was out of the net, and you could tell that he didn't know where the puck was. He was surprised to see that Cook had put it in the goal.
What a turn of events right now. Spectacular shorthanded effort.
Bobby was going to put in our Rivers Casino tips to win that the Penguins needed to score 2 shorthanded goals on the power play, but he forgot.
No, I forgot that one. I put the Richard Trophy winners beating the system. Well, we're beating their power play right now. The Penguins are in focus. The focus of Tampa not there. The Penguins trying to score. I like that. Look at this. Forcing the issue while they're shorthanded. They're dictating the pace. Stegi, you can see the great penalty killing units over the game. Over the years, I can look back to Ottawa, I can look back to Philadelphia when they were scoring shorthanded goals.
Saint-Louis from a sharp angle shoots the puck and it's absorbed by Marc-Andre Fleury and he hangs on to it.
I always thought in practice the power play units never have to play defense. As soon as the penalty killers get it, the coach blows the whistle typically. So they don't really know how to play defense. Force these guys to play defense. And the Penguins, they jumped up Chris Letang on the second goal to combine. I mean, that was incredible work right there.
There's a chance for Brett Clark as he tries to get it to the net. We're still on the same special team situation as the puck takes a crazy bounce right to the floor. Finally, the penalty is over, and onto the ice comes Dupuis. And the Lightning trying to make it happen now and see if they can tie this thing up. As the Grinders and the Energy Line, as they call them here in Tampa, on the ice again for Tampa Bay. They do have a goal already. But here come the Penguins. It's Dupuis firing off the stick of number 44, Nate Thompson. Back to the net, sticked away by Smith. Crosby's after behind the goal. Hedman able to take it away from him. Back around to the other side, and Paul Martin anticipating, gets to the puck, shields it beautifully away from Dana Tyrell, but finally it is Thompson rattling it off the glass and back up to the Penguin zone.
Quick up there, and the Penguins get a good quick change.
The Lightning, a little shell shock on their power play, but only one shot. Here's Lovejoy shooting. Oh, almost set up a good redirect opportunity for Comrie, who's still looking for his first goal for the Penguins.
Yeah, he should have had it. He got a little piece of that, not enough. He had himself a wide open net, and his first is a Penguin right there.
Comrie on the near wall, challenged by Pablo Kubina, of course, into the corner. Dupuis right there. Brooks Orpik shields Ryan Malone, wearing number six now for Tampa Bay. Up the right wing comes Letestu. Letestu shooting in the save made by Smith. Letestu trying to get to his own rebound, and he does get to the puck first. Out to Orpik, a shot, and Smith able to take that one and hold on to it. So the Penguins are doing what they want to do. They are dictating, as Bobby says, dictating the pace, and they're leading this game 2-1. Sidney Crosby's coach at Rimouski in junior hockey is the guy who's coaching the Lightning, 39-year-old Guy Boucher.
When people think it's because of his skills that he has success, they're sadly mistaken. I've seen some skilled guys that probably as much skill as he does, but it's the desire and the willingness to be the best and to do more all the time. He's obsessed by doing some things better and doing it faster, and that's why he's so good.
Guy Boucher, a highly regarded young coach, the youngest coach in the NHL, obviously has high regard for his former player, Sidney Crosby, and now the opponent tonight. Here's Malkin with a great move into the slot, and he got upended as he went for the puck at that last second on another one of those diving shot attempts. Now Letestu works into the corner for Gino. Malkin, beautiful pass to Martin, a shot. Went through traffic. I'm not sure it ever got to the net, but Paul Martin knows that he's got to shoot the puck a little bit more. He's gone four games without a shot, so he pulled the trigger that time. Now Letang kind of lost control of himself there as he came to center, and the Lightning turned it back the other way. Stamkos in after the puck. Wheels it quickly to center, wheel shot. And a save made by Marc-Andre Fleury. That's what I'm talking about. Telepathy. There's another setup from Saint-Louis, and he pushed it just wide of the goal. Turning shot again by Thompson. And a rebound. Oh, wide open net with Fleury down. Letang able to clear it. Up the right side for Tyler Kennedy. The Lightning get opportunities. They had 22 scoring chances to 11 the other night.
Martin Saint-Louis missed a wide open net there, making it 2-2. You talk about that telepathy. Stamkos to Saint-Louis early in the shift, and then a big, fat, juicy puck sitting on the doorstep.
They get pucks to the net. Another turning shot. That one missed the cage as Matias Rotola let it go. And the Lightning averaged 36 shots a game. Lead the NHL in that category. So they're really throwing pucks at the goal.
Yeah, Pens are up there. 31.6.
Now Dupuis after it. Well, they have a similar philosophy, Guy Boucher and Dan Bylsma, though they have different systems. The goal is the same, to get the puck up ice quickly, quick transition, and spend more time in the offensive zone. Backhanded into the Penguins' end, but Goligoski did a good job to prevent Nate Thompson from getting it deep. Right back to Victor Hedman, 6'6" defenseman out of Sweden. To the right wing now, and Dana Tenorel. Adam Hall goes to the net. He chips it to the side of the cage. Chris Kunitz works his own zone. He's bumped by his former teammate Adam Hall, and it's up over to the near side to Alex Goligoski. Kunitz after it again. Centers, and it's right there. But missing was Dupree. Down to the point of Torpik to the right side. Lovejoy a shot, and he sailed that one high and wide off the glass. Back comes Vinny LeCavalier, surrounded by Penguins. Lovejoy with a quick feet gets to the puck, keeps the puck moving. Crosby trying to get it out, couldn't do so. Held in by Sean Bergenheim, the former Islander first rounder. Now Crosby hustles over to break the play up. Moves it up the wing to Chris Kunitz. Kunitz gains the red line and dumps it into the Lightning zone. Penguins lead it 2-1, two shorthanded goals. One by Craig Adams and one by Matt Cook. Bergenheim shuffles it along for Kubina, sends it up the wall. Paul Martin's got to hustle to get there first ahead of Purcell, or Ryan Malone rather. And now Orpik finds Rupp, who feeds it down to the corner. Santoli hustled to get back to the puck. He sent it up the wall. Rupp right there trying to get control. But the Lightning able to bring it to center. Stamkos, good back checking by Adams, but maybe not good enough as he upended him. He called him off the skates inadvertently. And Craig Adams takes a penalty after scoring a shorty. He'll be watching the Penguins try to kill a penalty.
Earlier you heard Tampa head coach Guy Boucher speak very highly of Sidney Crosby, and they did work together back in the 04-05 season in Rimouski. Actually showed this picture to Sidney Crosby this morning. He smiled, and he said that was from the Memorial Cup. I think it was against, but he couldn't remember exactly, but he did remember that he learned a lot from Guy back in the day. They only spent one season together, but yet had some very nice things to say about him nonetheless.
Thanks, Dan. Yeah,
that's a great picture. Danny had that on his phone today, and that was all he was able to show it to Sid. And the technology is something else. You can get the things you need to put in the telecast. Guy Boucher is definitely a guy who is a progressive thinking coach. A very well-educated man from McGill University in Montreal. Interesting story, too, I'll tell you. A lot of interesting aspects to him. Here's LeCavalier moving it back to the line, and it's going to come back to center. The Lightning on their second power play chance. They registered only one shot and gave up two goals on their first one.
Yeah, last time the Penguins had two shorthanded goals in a game, April 11, 2009, against the Canadiens.
And they won that game 3-1. Mike Smith will move the puck here. Look out. Dupuis coming after him, and he'll keep it behind the cage. Halfway through the first period, the Penguins leading 2-1. In case you just joined us, the Lightning scored on their first shot, and the Penguins answered that. Here's Fleury trying to poke it away. Letang corrals the bouncing puck and then whips it up the boards and all the way into the Lightning zone.
No, the Penguins are oozing with confidence right now. You spend a couple of days in Florida, you want to make sure as a hockey player, you get out and you're prepared and ready to play for your coach. They extended kind of that courtesy to the Penguins to give them a couple of days in the sun. You want to make sure you're performing up to the level and above and beyond if you can.
Bertola tried to get it to the point. Cell centers. It comes all the way through to the right side, and Kubina, his shot sails right through the goal mouth. And Mike Rupp over to the puck, and he'll shovel it back into Lightning territory. 16 seconds remaining on the penalty to Craig Adams. Steve Downey shooting. That's off a stick. Downey had 22 goals a year ago. Breakout year for him offensively. Here's shot by Thompson. That hit a Lightning player in front. Purcell, and out come the Penguins. Adams is out of the box. He's got the puck. Here's Adams closing in. Looks for Dupuis to the goal. It's backhand. Score! A beautiful shot by Dupuis on the backhand. And the Penguins almost like another shorty, if you will, as they catch the Lightning at the end of their power play. With Adams just jumping on the ice, setting up Dupuis to make it 3-1.
Craig Adams has 3 points in this hockey game. When's the last time he had 3 points? Has it ever happened, I guess, is the question I'm asking you right now. And somebody look that up. Pascal Dupuis and the passing right now of the Penguins. I can't believe how precise it is. You talked about the ability of them to have that chance to practice here the last couple of days. The ice is obviously good. And I got to tell you, folks, this building is not cold. We go to a lot of buildings in the league. You're shivering. They're trying to get the ice to be flat and the puck to just glide steady. It's beautiful in here. The ice looks fast. It looks flat. And that man looks real flat. He's deflated, as a matter of fact. Smith is gone.
He is, and now we have a new goaltender named Dan Ellis, who was in goal the other night against the Nashville Predators. And Smith coming into this game and had a record of 3-3 against the Penguins. He was 4-0 on the year. So he's in danger of suffering his first loss, although there's a long way to go in this hockey game. The Penguins up 3-1. And the Lightning have the firepower and the ability to come back. So the Penguins will have to keep the pedal to the metal here. Here comes Comrie, and he dumps it to the corner. The Lightning are 2-1-1 on their home rink, 3-1 on the road. They have 11 points in the standing, same total as the Penguins. They played one fewer game than Pittsburgh. Now it's Malkin with it, turning out of the corner. Sets it up, Comrie. Shoots it, and it's blocked. He gets it back. Comrie back to the net. Ellis will steer it behind the goal. Malkin is there to Comrie. And out to Paul Martin. He can't get his shot through. Nate Thompson tries to get it out, and he does work it back to center.
Letestu trying to continue his hot start. He's tied for the rookie scoring race with Tyler Ennis, 7 points each. Boy, they took the crowd right out of this game. Everybody fired up to see this Stamkos Crosby festival, but it hasn't really turned that way yet.
Sean Bergenheim hopping back. Goes it in front. Fleury got a stick on it to direct it out to the stick of Tyler Kennedy, and he races back for the Penguins with Talbot. Now Asham shooting, and that hit Matthias Olin. It came right to the Lightning. Bergenheim. Three Penguins are back. Letellier joins the rush as Bergenheim sends it around to the other side for Brett Clark. Lovejoy over to confront him. Talbot works his own zone. Gave it away to Clark. Back in front, and it sails wide of the goal on the glove side of Fleury. Held in by Vernace to the corner for Downey. Letellier in front of Bergenheim, shuttled out the side of the cage, and then was upended going to the net.
No, he
went into the goal.
Yeah, he went in there and slew-footed Brooks Orpik going into the crease, and the referee got it. It's 3-1 right now. Tampa's not happy. Orpik just drew a penalty in front of his own net.
And Aaron Asham just lashed out at Steve Downey, Bob. And so Aaron Asham getting right back into the thick of things.
Man, there's Bergenheim. He's not a fighter. But Brooks Orpik said, you can't do that. We got a power play right now. But I can tell you, Brooks Orpik is telling Mr. Bergenheim he'll take care of business later as two combatants are rolling around the ice. I believe it's Lovejoy and Downey.
Well, it's interesting that those two ended up tangled up because Asham first reached for Downey and then Lovejoy ended up on the bottom of the pile. Three goals on seven shots chasing Mike Smith from the net, and Craig Adams getting involved in all three goals. And this is what's been happening on this road trip. Penguins going hard to the opposing net and drawing a crowd each time. A lot of scrums after the whistle. Brooks Orpik in front of his own net. There's Crosby going to the other team's net in St. Louis. And scrum after that. A lot of gloves to the face. And we saw another example of it here prior to the break.
Now this was in front of the Penguins.
Right. One of those was too with Orpik there.
Guy Boucher not happy with his club's ability. They were playing two perimeter in the last hockey game.
There's a shot by Malkin as the Penguins are on the power play. Letang to Malkin, back to Chris Letang. Now Goligoski in the slot. Oh, he ripped it just wide. Good chance for Goligoski. He got turned around. A lot of time to pull the trigger there. Letang with a shot, never got through. Chris Kunitz up the wall for Letang, who keeps it moving, and a good play by Malkin to keep it in. Over to Crosby, to Goligoski, right back to Sid. Now to Letang, backhand shot. And they have just clicked the stick of the goaltender, Dan Ellis. How about that puck movement? Precision passing by the Penguins. Here's Crosby, fakes the shot. Malkin. Goligoski. Gino, one-timer, missed the cage. I'm not sure Ellis saw that either.
It went off a body out high, and Penguins had their two offensive defensemen on the ice.
Crosby to Letang. Back to Sid. Fakes the shot. Works it down low for Kunitz. Sid again. Kunitz dancing with the puck out to Letang. He's looking for an open shot here. Moving players around. Malkin tried to thread it through. Adam Hall didn't get it out. Malkin hands it off to Letang. His shot deflected on net. Swept away by Ellis. Adam Hall to the puck. 9 seconds. Going to make that 31 seconds to go on the penalty. Sean Bergenheim is in the box for interfering with a goaltender, I assume.
No, interfering with Brooks Orpik.
Brooks Orpik?
Yeah. Okay. And I'll tell you right now, the Penguins,
There's a faster hockey team right now than the Tampa Bay Lightning.
And they're moving the puck faster, too. Another chance. Good save by Ellis on the short side on Ruck. And with second power play unit on now, Martin's got it. Closing in, goes right side. Malkin shooting, and it's blocked. Good play by Marty St. Louis out here until the end of the penalty. And now, back to the puck is Mark Letestu. Bergenheim's out of the box. And the Penguins are 0-1, but they got a lot of good looks at the net. They took a lot of shots. They're now 0 for their last 11 on the power play, but they've registered 10 power play shots in each of their last two games on this trip. So they're getting the opportunities, and they're making things happen. And the puck will go in on the power play if they keep doing that.
Well, when you have an opponent down like the Penguins have Tampa down here, you want to really keep the accelerator down.
Here's Purcell now shooting. He scores!
Did Staggy. He was drifting across from the center of the ice to the left, and as he was moving himself to the left, his feet were moving. One thing that means Marc-Andre Fleury's got to move from his left to his right. The puck goes against the grain and through traffic. Two bodies in front of that shot by Purcell. You see the one man going to the net right there. That's 21 Matias Rutola. He provides a little bit of a screen for Marc-Andre Fleury, and that puck is just snapped quickly in one motion over the glove hand.
First of the year, Eddie Purcell.
Yeah, he's 6 points though, and he's a +3 on the season now. That's a big boost to a Tampa team that really was flattering. Here's a 1-3-1 right here, the best example we've seen all night of that Lightning, and then it's a turnover by the Penguins trying to deal with it.
And it's Bergenheim shooting, and he hits Martin, he gets it back, he shoots it. Fleury standing up, takes it into the chest protector and hangs onto it. And there's another one of those battles around the net. And I'll tell you, the other night it was a big difference because against Nashville, the Lightning didn't do much of that.
Yeah, let's take a look at this 1-3-1 if we can in that neutral zone that Kubiche says isn't, but it really is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You got one at the point, three in the middle, and look at the guy way back playing net. He's like the safety back there. Looks like football positioning. Dan Bosma called it a 1-3-1. Boucher said we got a lot of different formations of that we can change, metamorphosize, as he puts it. Our guys can be in different positions, but the defense is in the middle of the three in the center. There's one defense down there between the hash marks in front of the goalie, and then a point guy there kind of just filtering traffic left or right. Stag, it's very stagnant, if you will, and the Penguins have to deal with it. I know that Dan Bosma has looked at a lot of tape and he's got some ideas.
I don't know why Boucher refuses to refer to it as a 1-3-1, but you just have to look at it, and that's what it is at the neutral zone. Certainly, they're not going to play that way every time. But now a shot from the point by Clark is blocked by Adams. And what's interesting, too, is that if you have a defenseman back like that, if you dump the puck in, he's way back there to be able to go retrieve the puck right away. So in that sense, it makes sense because your D don't have to turn and go back to get it. You already got a guy way back there. It's like a safety valve to go back and get those shoot-ins. Take a look at our day automotive this day in Penguins history, Bob.
Pat Buttet, he hit the hat trick against the Caps. His second career hat trick. One of my old teammates. Except I didn't play in 82, Staggy. I'm not quite that old.
I still can see Pat Buttet skating around without a helmet and a stick up over his head. He protected himself well with the lumber. Centering pass by Stamkos, and it comes right to the other Rocket Richard Trophy winner, Sidney Crosby. Pushed ahead by Englund deep into the zone, and now Blake St. Louis comes back to center ice. Letestu takes the puck right away from him, hands it off quickly to Malkin. Letestu looking to get open for Malkin. Instead, he goes to Goligoski, who rips it in deep, right on the puck. Quick shot again. Boy, Ruck got himself free a couple of times off to the left of the goal in this first period. Minute 50 to go in the period. We get an offside call against Tampa Bay.
Yeah, that was great gap there about Goligoski against Steven Stamkos. He didn't want to give him the blue line, and he made it very tough. He tried to stay tight to Stamkos. He didn't want to give him that distance between himself and the man. Watch. Look, he's keeping the blue line, keeping the blue line, and then the puck right there hops over the stick of Stamkos, who was trying to sweep it in. And when you're a great skater like Goligoski, you can do that even against a great skater in Steven Stamkos. You can really have to play him one-on-one, battle him like that. Much like football, Staggy, when you're being the defender. Sometimes, you know, you want to get that chuck on the line. You don't want to give a good receiver that distance between you.
Got to get his speed up and have you on your heels.
Yeah, exactly. So the Penguins right now are using their defense and their speed and their mobility and their confidence to not only
body.
Score goals, yeah, not only score goals, but to prevent goals. I mean, it's unbelievable. Uncanny work here right now.
Letellier pushes it wide of the net. Bergenheim back to the goal. Fleury juggled it, and fortunately bounced off of his arm and behind the net, not into it.
Strange.
Now Letellier again. Dangerous behind the goal. They do like to set things up from behind the cage. Puck kisses the glass over there on the far side and back out to center.
Would have been a penalty. It's the Pens who went over that glass.
Final minute of the period, which has been very entertaining. And we have goals, lots of them. Five already in this hockey game. 3-2 Pittsburgh. And from unlikely sources, Daniel Tyrell with his first NHL goal. Adams with a first goal.
He's unbelievable. He's got a season going right now for Adams, who was the Iron Man, 85 straight. He was a healthy scratch for a couple of games. He's been on a tear right now. I mean, you don't really measure Craig Adams with points, but you got to feel good for the man right now in this period.
There's the 1-3-1, and the puck comes right to the safety valve. Brett Clark moves it up, but it comes right to Kuntz. Shoots the puck, and it's off a stick wide of the goal. You still have to make the right play out of your own zone, even if you get the puck first. 8 seconds to go in the period. A lead pass beyond the reach of Sidney Crosby. Back to get it goes Mike Lundin. And the Lightning will just watch the clock tick away here at the end of a very entertaining first period. But the Lightning are very much in this hockey game, despite the fact that the Penguins scored 3 goals.
Now, there's a man that will not win the Rocket Richard Award, and I'm pretty sure about that, in Craig Adams. But, boy, he was on fire. He was like a rocket in the first period for the Pittsburgh Penguins. Two of them coming shorthanded. You take a look at the numbers there. Fort Pitt Capital by the number, Steggy. What we don't see is the two shorthanded goals that really changed that hockey game for the Penguins in the first.
College football.
Here's a turnover, and all alone in front, Volsky, but Hiller made the save.
Bumped in the corner, but finds Samuelson. Hard shot, rebound, Torres can't find it. Alberts, rebound, scores!
Fowler scores! Off the post and in.
Now the puck center of attack, leading Raymond, scores!
Perry behind the net for Bobby Ryan. Ryan with a little space, great pass, Lupin roofs it! What a pass behind the back by Bobby Ryan!
Stepniak puts it off the crossbar.
It was Perry scoring! What a great feed from Getzlaf!
As Glass gets the puck in front, Sanderson scores! Patrick O'Sullivan shoots, he scores!
The shot off the post and in from Scotty Upshaw. Stepniak in front, Hiller looked behind him, but he made the save. He bounces to Doan, hands it off, score!
Near side, Kessler with a drive, scores! Comes out on the backhand, Raymond stuck into the night!
What if I told you he wasn't the greatest? That a country would fail to protect its greatest natural resource? That sometimes it is a matter of life and death? That no one can outrun the truth? What if I told you he's the only true Cubs fan? That you can heal all wounds with a fight song. That the man no one could stop tragically was. What if I told you running a marathon is easy? 30 stories, 30 filmmakers, 30 years. ESPN's critically acclaimed 30 for 30. All this month on ESPN America.
Welcome back to Tampa Bay. The Penguins have lost 2 of their last 3 games against Tampa Bay, and the teams have combined for a total of 9 goals in those 3 games, 6 by the Lightning. So only 9 goals in 3 games, and yet 5 goals in the first period of this one. So a departure from what we've been seeing from these two clubs when they go head-to-head in the last few games. a welcome departure. We like offense. It's always fun to see goals scored.
We do, but coaches like defense. And for the Penguins, their team defense is fifth in the National Hockey League coming into this game. That's pretty impressive. 20th last year. Le Cavalier, zero shots. Stamkos, zero shots in the first period.
Chris Kunitz moves it along. The Penguins jump out of their own zone. Crosby takes a pass from Dupuis. Around Hedman. Sit on his backhand, and he backhanded it through the goal mound. Now Kunitz over to the wall, try to keep it in. Adam Hall there as well. And Letang wins the battle against Hall and pushes the puck in behind the net. And Ellis back there to handle it.
Pretty good speed there for Crosby. He's been held without a goal in four straight against Tampa and 10 of his last 11 games. And he doesn't really produce much. His second worst point production is against the Tampa Bay Lightning. In the East, only Ottawa at 0.83 points per game. Sidney has the worst point production. Sidney Crosby, look at this, inside out around a big defenseman who's going to be good, but he couldn't match Crosby right there.
And yet he has scored two of the most spectacular goals that we've seen him score against the Lightning. So even though he hasn't scored a lot of them, they've seen him at his most amazing.
And has Guy Boucher as well, as we mentioned earlier, behind that bench. They know what he can bring in any given second. He'll just bite you.
Pavel Kubina, back in a Lightning uniform, originally drafted by them in the seventh round, way back in 96. Here's those two goals. Lowell McDonald's amazing, our producer. We talked about it, and all of a sudden, Bob, there it is. He's got it there for us.
Well, he's absolutely incredible, isn't he? How about that? The pass right by Corey Sarich. Crosby looks around him, goes down to one knee. Thank you very much. Another one around Dan Boyle, a pretty darn good defenseman. As a matter of fact, Dan Boyle, with 65 goals, is tied with Pavel Kubina for the most in Tampa Bay franchise history. Kubina on the ice right now wearing 13 in his second stint of duty with the Lightning.
Penalty.
A trip.
Comrie went down, but he's also going to the box, so.
Pittsburgh minor penalty number 19, 2 minutes, tripping.
Well, I'd like to tell you it's a bad thing. The Penguins have two shorthanded goals, and just looking at Craig Adam, the 3 points, two shorthanded ones in the first period of play. As you look at the penalty right there in the neutral zone, oh, right there, that didn't look like much at all to me. And Mr. Adams has had 3 3-point games in his career, never a 4-point game.
Lecavalier, Malone, and Stamkos up front. Clark and Saint-Louis also. Lightning going with 7D tonight. There's a shot to the net. Malone there looking for the rebound, jamming away at it. They get a quick whistle. The puck wasn't frozen. So a break there for Marc-Andre Fleury, who kind of tipped over backwards into the goal as that puck was sitting out in front of him in the paint.
Ryan Malone wearing number 6. He was one of the 4 numbers he wore in college hockey. The puck's loose, and he's going to keep whacking. The puck is still loose, but the referee right there on the left of your screen lost sight of it. He'll blow that whistle. Malone threw it in there anyway. It's really weird and strange to see a number 4 forward and a number 6 forward, and they're on the ice together right now. Lecavalier with 4, Malone wearing 6.
Marty Saint-Louis, look at Stamkos. He's in the slot. Lecavalier throws it in front. Stamkos was there, poked away just at the last second before he could pull the trigger. And now the Penguins, with a good stick by Alex Goligoski, redirect the puck back to center. And Stamkos takes the pass, steps into the zone, looks for Malone. And Malone off to a slow start. Has only one goal. He's got limited ice time, but he's always on the power play. Lecavalier moves it to Clark. Gets turned around to look to the net. Can't shoot it. As Orpik was in his face. Now Stamkos behind the net. Goligoski took it away from him. Stamkos hustles to the puck, able to get it out to Clark. Back towards the net. And it never got there. A turning shot by Malone. He gets the puck again. Malone behind the net. Nobody's in front. He goes to Saint-Louis on the far side. Stamkos looking for that one-timer. Posted up in the circle to the right of Fleury. That's his dangerous spot. But they don't get him the puck as the Penguins force it back to center. Stamkos has scored only one goal from that spot this year. Teams are really expecting it, and they're keeping an eye on him in that circle.
And that's when a guy like Saint-Louis or Lecavalier is going to have to do the damage.
Lecavalier with it. Cross ice. Good chance. Fleury not able to see the puck right away, but it trickled by the net on the chance by Bergenheim. And now to the near side. Tyrell with it. Dana Tyrell. Off the boards for Stamkos. And a Bergenheim. Lecavalier is at the point along with Kubina. Rotola with it, rather. He moves it behind the net for Stamkos. Now Matias Rotola with it again on the corner. Kearns out of the corner, pulls the trigger, and it's blocked. Penguins doing a good job of getting in front of shots. Lightning are getting opportunities to look at the net and shoot the puck, but the Penguins aren't letting that puck get through. Now here comes Adams back. Adams shooting, and a save made by Ellis with a blocker. Another after a penalty. Penguins getting good chances right after penalties expire.
Yeah, they did. That's how they scored the Dupuis goal. It came out of the penalty box, and another great chance there.
Centering pass beyond the reach of Kunitz. Nate Thompson moves it up ahead to Adam Hall. Tyrell cuts to the net, and his backhand chance. Got a shot off there. A good nifty play by Tyrell, and Fleury made the save. Now Asham moves it back to Paul Martin. Up to Letang. We'll drop it off to Kunitz. Back for Chris Letang, who moves up on the play. Behind the net for Aaron Asham. Crosby goes to work on his knees, able to center the puck. And it comes right back to the Penguins, and it's dumped in by Asham behind the net. Sid there again. So Asham getting a chance to play on the right wing with Crosby and Kunitz.
After the penalty kill, we out there killing penalties to go with Asham.
Letang down low for Sid. Couldn't get himself straightened out to shoot it. But he finds Engelin, who hands it off to Malkin. Gino with a good pass to Kunitz. Engelin can cross to Letang. Back for Derek Engelin. He risks the puck, and it's a blocker save made by Ellis, and nobody in front of the net. Crosby's dead tired. He will head off the end of his shift. Penguins change as Derek Engelin goes back for the puck in his own zone. A long lead pass to Malkin. He's got Letestu open. Here he is. It's shot. Ellis got to the post to make the save. Now Engelin cuts it off in front of LeCavalier, but falling on his Purcell. Eddie Purcell down the wing, got poke checked, and Tyler Kennedy follows on to take the puck over to Brooks Orpik.
The speed of this game is really increased right from halfway through in the first leg, and it's not just the feet, it's the way the puck is moving.
Kennedy shooting, and Ellis in good position makes the save on Tyler Kennedy.
The puck is just flying around the ice. The Penguins made seven tape-to-tape passes. I don't think you could keep up to that call, could you? I'm going to have to replay that to see if you were able to pick up... that precision passing. And there's Dan Ellis.
Let's take a look at our barrel leaders right now, if we can. Steven Stamkos has got 8. Crosby's got 6. And they finished both with 51 last year, the tie for the Rocket Richard.
Sid and Stamkos each have 3 power play goals this year. Stamkos had 24 last year. Sid had 13. That was a big difference. Stamkos had 41 power play points in total. And the special teams of the Lightning coming into this game, very good. I mean, their power play ranked 4th, their penalty killing ranked 5th. The Penguins burned their power play for a couple of shorthanded goals. Neither team has scored on the power play. Now Fleury has to hug the post. Saint-Louis was right there hacking away at the puck. Now Saint-Louis behind the net. Orpik steps in front of him. Puck squirts out to Ryan Malone. To Saint-Louis, but he can't do anything with it. And the Penguins counter, and it's Max Talbot with it. Talbot digging in. Poke checked nicely by defenseman Randy Jones. And now Dupuis sends the puck towards the net. Delayed offside in effect. Matias Olland loses the puck, and the whistle blows.
Craig Adams coming out of the penalty box, looking for his 4th point of the night.
There's a look at the new number 6 for the Tampa Bay Lightning, though number 6 is not that new to Ryan Malone, as Bob Airey mentioned. He wore it in college at St. Cloud State, but he also wore 15, 29, and 12. In fact, my friends at St. Cloud State told me that he was an equipment manager's nightmare. Didn't get a chance to find out why he wore so many different numbers this morning, because the Lightning did not skate this morning here in Tampa. Guys?
Ironically, Ryan Malone was traded to the Lightning for a 3rd-round pick, which turned out to be Ben Hanowski, high school kid out of Minnesota who was a prolific scorer in high school. He's now playing at St. Cloud State, same place. Puck to the goal, and Fleury sweeps it aside.
Another part of that trade was Gary Roberts, was it not?
Yes.
Gary Roberts was a man that a lot of people... credited with really bulking up Steven Stamkos, putting 20 pounds on him one summer, just really showing him the advantage of a great diet, a good work session,
And Fiji water, probably, Steggy.
He's done that with a lot of players, Bob, over the last couple of years. He did it with quite a few this summer, too. And now he's been hired by the Dallas Stars.
Yeah, him and Newendike right back together in the Calgary days.
By the way, Dan Ellis.
This. Steggy, I thought the whistle had blown. Everybody stopped. And Dan Bosma told me, he said, if we get the lead and they go in this 1-3-1, I'm going to tell my defenseman to just stop behind the net. And I thought for a second there that the whistle had gone. There was 10 guys on the ice and nobody was moving.
So what's the reason? We'll get to that in a moment, why they would stop.
I stop. Penguins have the lead. The clock doesn't stop. When you stop, you're milking the clock. You don't have to go anywhere. You move back and forth and just drain the clock. Just stand there until the fans boo, and that's it.
Well, the Lightning are in a structure of a 1-3-1, right?
But they weren't moving.
They were not forcing
that player to do anything.
So if you stand behind the net, you got to make somebody make a decision as to what they're going to do to come after you.
Right. You circle the net. Yeah, I mean, they're standing way back by the blue line. The first guy, three at the red line, and the other one behind their own blue line.
Now Goligoski goes back for the puck into his own zone. Moves it out. Crosby tapped it back to Aaron Asham. Run into traffic, but leave it for Alex Goligoski. The mobility of Goligoski bringing it up. He centers. Always an option for the Penguins. Get the puck to somebody who can make something happen with it. When you have a defenseman who can do what Goligoski did right there, it just completely gives you a whole new layer of attack.
You know, it certainly does. I mean, Goligoski has led the Penguins in ice time four of the last five games, despite the fact that, you know, he does play 200 feet. He's up and down the ice, and there's a collision in the neutral zone. And this penalty is going against
either Tyrell or Dupuis. They collided with one another, and it looks like it's going to be Dupuis again. He's been getting a rash of minor penalties lately.
Pittsburgh number 9, 2 minutes for the first.
Penguins are trying to get some movement against that 1-3-1. As they move the puck back, there's the interference by Pascal Dupuis, just trying to get back to his spot. And he was in the box when the Penguins scored their two shorthanded goals in the first period of play. So the Lightning, who have now not converted on 24 consecutive power plays on home ice. They are 0 for 24 on their power play. The last 24 power plays against the Penguins on home ice.
And they're 0 for 3 tonight with two shots and two goals scored against them.
And look at Stamkos. Look at this faceoff configuration. The Lightning have two players. There's a broken stick by LeCavalier at the faceoff. If you look down here at the bottom of the screen, you're going to see two Lightning players. That one, this one here, he's the deadly one. Steven Stamkos, number 91. If he gets a puck, he's going to fly out this way with it and rip it right to the net. That's what they're looking for.
The other one is Ryan Malone, and Malone wants to get to the puck in the corner, but Letang got there first because Paul Martin interfered with Malone off the draw. Now Saint-Louis shoots it. Oh, and kicked out of there by Fleury. You don't see him do the splits very often, but that's what he did there. That was a kick save and a beauty. Now LeCavalier throws it back to the net. Picked off in front and cleared by Letang the length of the ice. And
Malone is barking at the official. He thought he got hit right into Marc-Andre Fleury. Letang just cleaned house. Malone just got hammered.
Saint-Louis on the puck again. Chips it to the corner. Saint-Louis comes out of the corner with it. Goligoski and Martin defending on him. Ryan Malone trying to work to the front of the net.
A high stick to the face. Sorry, Staggy. It was a high stick to the face of Stamkos. And so it's either going to be two or four. And Letang goes down the runway. That's not good for the Penguins. They're not playing with seven, and that's an NHL's leading scoring defenseman. Chris Kunitz along the wall, just inadvertent high stick on Stamkos. It came up under his face, under his visor area. He snapped his head back. That drew the penalty. A 5-on-3 now. There's no Chris Letang. I don't know why Chris Letang went down, but in that collision, there's 14 Kunitz stick, right? He's just turning. Stick rides up the arm into the face. Letang, he doesn't need to be down there. They don't need an injury to him right now.
We had a quick shot of him on the bench, hunched over after he had gone to the bench, and then he was gone down the runway.
Yeah, and then something must have happened in that collision between him and Ryan Malone and Marc-Andre Fleury in front of the net.
Stamkos showing good speed down the wing this time against Brooks Orpik. Pulls up. Down he goes to the front of the net along with Ryan Malone. Two players in front as LeCavalier holds it at the point. Stamkos sets it up for Saint-Louis to LeCavalier. He scores. Mm-hmm.
have a backside power play. The movement was really nice there between two guys that have been known to have a ton of telepathy. They have five forwards on the ice, and there they slide out. Matt Cook and the two Penguins are a little tight together on St. Louis. Take a look. Adams and Cook. Cook tried to slide over, but Vinny LeCavalier kind of did the moonwalk backwards.
That puck was delivered beautifully by St. Louis to LeCavalier, who was moving out and away from Matt Cook. So it was tough for Cookie to get in the lane and tough for Marc-Andre Fleury to track that puck.
Which went back against the grain. Fleury moving from right to left. The shot went back to his right as he was going from right to left. So LeCavalier with a pinpoint shot on the 5-on-3, and the Lightning have tied this game at 3. And they have more time to work with. A minute 13 to go on the high sticking penalty to Chris Kunitz.
And Dan Ellis is the goaltender of record now, not Mike Smith.
That's why I said earlier, there's still a lot of hockey to play in this game, and it has that feeling of some crazy things are happening before the night's over. Purcell shot it. Tolo is upended in front of the net. The Penguins able to come back. Shorthanded again. Goligoski with it. And he will feed it down to the corner.
Well, breaks a string of over 24 against the Penguins on home ice for Tampa. It took a 5-on-3 to do it.
Kubina carries the puck into the gauntlet. And the Penguins come out with it. Lovejoy sending it down the ice. Hedman back. Adams takes it away from him. And then Hedman gets it back and moves it out to LeCavalier. Look out here, Stamkos and Fritz! Oh, St. Louis got a stick on that puck, but directed it wide of the goal. A great layup attempt there.
Nice pass by Stamkos, who looked high in the slot and then went to the front of the net with that pass.
Stamkos flying. He wanted the puck from Brett Clark, and he didn't give it to him. And he was motoring as he went to the blue line there. He can really skate, too. LeCavalier to the corner. LeCavalier can't pull the trigger. Cook couldn't get it out. St. Louis with a shot. That was blocked by Lovejoy. A scramble for the puck. Fleury's down. It comes right at front. Pushed wide of the goal by Stamkos.
Batted it right out of the air. That was a fabulous play by Stamkos. He's been known to score some goals by whacking that puck out of midair.
Kunitz out of the penalty box. Moves it along to Sidney Crosby. Pulls up. Finds the trailer. The shot taken by Rupp is off a stick wide of the goal. Anglin down the wall for Crosby. Coming up. The fans not happy.
Well, Stamkos, he's flying. He may have not got the puck one time. Look at this. He looks high, goes low.
Well, Steven Stamkos is going to follow this puck, if you can, right up in the air here. He's going to whack it. Goes wide. And Steven Stamkos, his hand-eye coordination is right there with Crosby and Malkin. To me, he scored a beautiful goal. It was a really highlight goal last year on his can, able to knock it in out of the air, backhanded.
Spectacular stuff. As long as the puck's under the crossbar, you can do that. And some people say, hey, this shouldn't count. It sticks over his shoulders. Not on a goal here. It's got to be down below the crossbar. It makes it easy for everybody, despite your height.
Stamkos is in the box, and look out now, a shorthanded chance for Nate Thompson to the goal. He hit the goal post. He went upstairs, he beat Fleury, but he didn't finish the play, and now the Penguins counter on the power play. Their second chance, they're 0-for-1. Malkin down the wing. We'll use the back of the net now. Back up top for Sid, and back to Gino. He and Crosby play catch. Comrie to Sid, near side of Goligoski, and the shot off of Lundin, and it goes up out of play.
Tampa Bay, right off the faceoff, defensive zone, get a great opportunity. Crosby's not liking it right now, but the puck comes through. Malkin loses a foot race. That's the one negative of having a defenseman trying to turn. His ability, Malkin's not quite as good as a defenseman's would be to turn, per se, a Chris Letang, who's injured right now, who could turn from backwards to forwards a little bit more quickly. But then, did you see that puck movement by the Penguins on the power play? Using the man in the middle, back out, that triangular formation up high.
Well, the Penguins wanted more player movement on their power play this year, and boy, do they get it. I mean, they're all over the place in the offensive zone. It's got to make it tougher for the penalty killers to keep track. They were so stationary before. You could close your eyes and you knew where everybody was, Bob, but it's not like that anymore.
No, not at all.
Goligoski drops it off to Kunitz. Comrie centers in off a stick. Malkin was headed to the net looking for a bang-bang play, but it didn't happen. Now So important on the power play to win those battles, and the Penguins win it. Goligoski taking the pass from Kunitz to Comrie. Off the stick and cleared by Covina down the ice.
They tried to use that man in the middle again of the house. It was Comrie this time who couldn't hold that puck. And there's different players that assume those positions.
Now a chance for Malone in front. Another layup attempt for San Luis. Boy, he goes for the net and they find him, right?
I got to tell you that. Marc-Andre Fleury made a spectacular save here with his glove. He waved it up there. St. Louis did just get enough wood, and I think it was in. He flashed the glove up, and it just caught part of his glove hand. What a save. Talk about these chances. They are driving that. Both these hockey teams play a little bit of the similar style offensively. They go.
Now Malkin with it. 10 seconds to go on the penalty to Steven Stamkos, and the Lightning clear.
This is one of these games you just put your seatbelt on and go for the ride. What a tremendous hockey game here. 3-3 in Tampa Bay.
Tyler Kennedy down the wing. He shoots it off the stick of Randy Jones, and it goes up into the netting behind the Lightning goal. Dan Ellis now in the net for Tampa Bay. Signed by a free agent. As a free agent, there's a look at that save by Fleury and St. Louis, who drove to the net. Oh, yeah.
Watch the glove. Just get a piece of it. Oh, what a save by Marc-Andre Fleury to keep it 3-3. Lightning fighting back here. They had a closed-door meeting after the last game against Nashville. The coach wasn't happy. Needed more from the boys.
Centering pass by Letestu goes right through the goal mouth. Tyler Kennedy couldn't play it. And all the way back up into the Penguin zone it goes. And you hear the thumping on the boards when we get another penalty coming up.
Penguins just got through with their second power play of the night.
Tampa, number 48.
Here's where Letang hit Malone. And what do you see? Malone may be falling out.
No, it's like the puck. Yeah, the puck hit Letang as he was colliding. He took the shot right on the arm or the hand.
That's nice. That's not nice. I mean that. I'm kidding when I say that. Don't take my words.
Yves Boucher not happy with a call on his player, Michael Vernace. And Vernace is in the box, and the Penguins have another opportunity with the power play, which is 0-for-2, with three shots on goal.
Nobody knew who had the penalty there, and I think he wants just an explanation, does Yves Boucher? Hey, I'm the youngest coach in the league. Doesn't mean you can't talk to me.
Well, you could be the oldest coach in the league, and they might not talk to you. That's just the way it is. Here's Malkin with it, over to Goligoski. Gino up top to Crosby, a one-timer. Oh, hit Lundin and knocked him down. And he is shaken up. They get a whistle.
Well, yeah, he sat down. The Penguins wanted the play to continue there, but the referee deemed that Lundin was in a vulnerable position. Maybe his health in jeopardy as he blocked that shot, that high shot by Sidney Crosby. Falling back. The weight is more forward than I thought, but he's down on one knee. The puck comes up high. Lundin's down as well.
You've got to be careful because the players have gotten seriously injured from shots hitting them in the chest.
You're exactly right.
And his heart stop on him from that. So
it's hard to block a shot when you're that far away from the players, Daggy. Your distance, if you're close to the guy, look out.
Bergenheim, Malkin trying to get back to prevent him from getting a great chance. Fleury makes the save on Bergenheim. It'll be a penalty shot for Sean Bergenheim.
It has to be. It has to be. He had a clear lane, prevented him from getting a great opportunity. He still had a good opportunity, but it affected his way to make a perfect opportunity. And this is one of the new things in the league. The old days, probably doesn't get a penalty shot. Now, they want more goals. They want more excitement. I don't mind it. That's another. We've said already, Malkin on the point. A couple of breakaways behind Evgeny Malkin here in the last 10 minutes of this game.
Well, it's a 3-3 hockey game. Needless to say, this is a gigantic opportunity for the Lightning. The crowd on their feet. Let's see if Bergenheim can deliver. Fleury stops him cold. He stopped him twice. And the score remains 3-3. And the Penguins' power play will continue with Vernace in the box for Ruffin.
Well, Bergenheim has had a great start here. He's found chemistry with Vinny LeCavalier a little bit here in Tampa Bay. Coming over from the island. He's got 3 goals already on the season.
denied there.
I always liked them. I'm surprised the Islanders let him get away.
Talk about timely save by Marc-Andre Fleury. How about on St. Louis, the glove hand, the penalty shot there. He's been spectacular in a 3-3 game. Sometimes it's when you make the saves, not how many. It's when you make them, the timeliness of them. And right now, Marc-Andre Fleury is making that timely save.
And gaining confidence with every one.
And they're going to need them. And then, unfortunately, both of these offenses,
some of the better chances have come shorthanded tonight, quite frankly.
And maybe you don't go with five forwards. Maybe you got to be... You got to be cognizant of who you got back there.
Well, even if you go with all defensemen, sometimes they move up. There's a centering pass and Rafa Velas. So you'll find forwards back there, whether they're defensemen on the ice or not.
45.
The way the Penguins rotate their players around on the power play.
Maybe if they're up by two goals, they don't rotate quite as much, and they make sure they keep the defensemen back. But it's a 3-3 hockey game. It's anybody's game. It's up for grabs.
Well, test to the Crosby. Up top. There he is. He feeds it over to Veligoski. Now into the slot through to Crosby. He's had to tee it up with the glove. And that's how hard he works to get the puck back here. And the Penguins end up with a Letestu to Goligoski. And he can't play it. Looked up, didn't play the puck. And now St. Louis pressuring Goligoski. Runs right over him. Lecavalier follows on. St. Louis got the puck. Penalty coming up. Here's St. Louis dancing with a puck. Moves it back for Stamkos. A shot. And the whistle blows. And I was waiting for a whistle there. And it finally did blow. And the Penguins have allowed some shorthanded opportunities to push them into a position of having to take a penalty.
Well, take a look at this stuff by St. Louis. This is why you win MVPs, because you force pucks, you draw penalties because you keep your feet moving. This man's 5'8", 175 pounds. Watch this play. You're going to keep going, throw it between his legs. I mean, incredible work by a talented hockey player. We see it a lot in Pittsburgh. I guess they see it a lot in Tampa, too. And that's why we talk about this high talent stag. These first overall and second overall picks in this hockey game. The Penguins are 0-for-3 on their power play with four shots. And we're playing a little 4-on-4 hockey right now.
Penguins are 0-for-3 on the power play now. And the Lightning fire. Clark with a shot. Vernace comes out of the box. And Goligoski in the box for another minute 47, and the Lightning with an opportunity here to take the lead with a man advantage. They couldn't do it with a penalty shot or a shorthanded breakaway. Now it's taken by Clark. Tampa Bay is 1-for-5 on the power play.
Yeah, that came on a 5-on-3 opportunity, and we tried to the Kunitz high stick on Stamkos, and we still have not seen Chris Letang after he was struck by a errant shot.
St. Louis pulls up on the wall. Stamkos is open, cross ice. Can they get it through to him? He's moving into the slot now. Clark takes it. Stamkos in the high slot. Ryan Malone's in front of the net. Adams had a stick on the puck, but then he fell down. Lecavalier to St. Louis. Now to Stamkos, a one-timer. And the Penguins got over there. And got in front of that stick just as he was pulling the trigger on that deadly one-timer. Cook with a blast wide of the goal, shorthanded. 45 seconds to go on the penalty.
Look at that bounce. Credit that play to Lovejoy. Coming out there, reading the play, cheating over to Stamkos, denying that one-timer on the last opportunity by the Lightning. Beautiful play by Lovejoy. To delay it offside, and they're going to bring this, and this doesn't happen too often. Shorthanded, they're going to bring the faceoff all the way back. Take a look at Lovejoy. Lovejoy in front of the net, number 6 for the Penguins. Here he is here, but he's going to move out to Stamkos to deny. He's going to go already. Look at that. Get the stick out there. There you go. Nice job. And normally Letang probably gets that challenge. Letang not being there, Lovejoy up to the challenge.
Teams are taking it away now. As I said earlier, Stamkos has 3 goals. One of them has come on that one-timer from that circle this year. He scored a ton of them from that spot last year. He had 24 power play goals, and I'll bet you 15 of them were from that circle.
Yeah, he's really never scored here against the Penguins in his 8 career games. But he did score one in Pittsburgh just like that.
5 seconds remaining, down to 3 on Goligoski. Downey barges through Orpik. Purcell went to the front of the net. Now Purcell's got the puck on his stick. Out here with Rotola and Downey. Rotola protects the puck in the corner against Engelin, but then just gives it right to Pascal Dupuis. who sends Alex Goligoski on the charge, and he's leading the charge. Three Lightning back. Goligoski sends it around behind the net, appeals over to the bench at the end of his shift.
Yeah. The Penguins ended up with three defensemen on the ice because of the penalty situation. So Goligoski was like a center there.
Asham sets it up. Crosby to the net. And he puts the puck to the goal mouth, and the save made by Ellis. Crosby almost got a stick on a rebound there after Ellis made the first save. With Crosby falling down, he got the shot away.
Oh, yes. With one hand on the stick. Look at that.
Woo. Our AGH injury update brought to you by Allegheny General Hospital Sports Medicine, helping athletes of all levels return to the game. And, boy, everybody seems to be ready to come back, except for maybe Zbynek McCulloch, who's now skating and participating. But Jordan Staal not far away, Bob.
Nope. I'm just worried about Chris Letang, quite honestly, right now. I haven't seen him. There he is. He's on the left point. I'm not worried about Chris Letang anymore. Chris Letang has made an appearance, Daggy. He's on the left point right now.
Teams at full strength. A rarity in this period. And now Martin pushes it ahead. Handled by Kunitz. Fires, and a save by Ellis. Dan Ellis was with Nashville last year. And he had a record of 15-13-1 in 31 appearances with the Predators. Signed as a free agent by Tampa. He originally broke in with the Dallas Stars. He was actually in the organization with Mike Smith, the man who replaced tonight. So those two are partners who go way back all the way to the Dallas organization. They've got a good relationship as they battle to be the number one goaltender. And Ellis has filled in nicely for Smith, who allowed 3 goals on 7 shots and was sent to the bench. Face off to the left of Dan Ellis
against ex-Penguin Adam Hall.
Crosby right there on the draw. The puck came through. And Ellis was waiting for that. I don't know if Sid got a good shot there or not, but Ellis was certainly able to see the puck coming all the way off the draw.
You can remember a right-handed centerman, Jason Spezza, take a face-off in his own circle. That circle, he went in it towards your own net, Staggy. You remember the Penguins had a great chance, and Malkin scored a goal against that face-off. This time, Crosby, they said, hey, we're going to go forward with the puck. He's going to go towards the net. We're going to use that to our advantage. And Asham helped out by kicking that puck towards Crosby. So Adam Hall is going to try to go towards his net. I don't like this play. I never like this play. So if Lundin moves up the defense, at least Sidney Crosby wide open.
He did get a good chance, too. He turns to the forehand.
That? Oh, what an opportunity by the Penguins there off that faceoff.
Jones dumps it around to the other side. Centered right past Stamkos to the near wall, where it's taken by Jones, and he'll rifle it wide again. Picked up by Tyler Kennedy, and he'll hop out of his own zone. Tyler Kennedy. Over to Lovejoy, who rifles it up into the Lightning zone of the corner. Kennedy hustled all the way in there to get on the puck first. Malkin follows on to win the battle. Malkin's tripped on the near wall. It'll be a penalty. Tyler Kennedy goes to the point. There's the shot. And Orpik shot off the side of the cage. Still up for grabs. Finally, Bergenheim gets possession to draw the whistle. So Malkin was upended, drawing a penalty on the near wall, and the Penguins will get a power play chance. Less than a minute remaining in the period.
Well, he's drawing penalties. He's not taking any. He's gone 8.5 games without taking a penalty.
Evgeny Malkin. That's a 100 penalty minute guy last year.
2 minutes for tripping.
In this hockey game, both Malkin and Crosby have a shot apiece. They've each had 3 blocked, but persistence does pay off.
And keep shooting. Let's take a look at the penalty. See how he protected the puck first, and then he was tripped by the stick that was on the ice. The man fell down. And basically Malkin tripped on a stick, stepped on it.
Hurstle's in the box, and the Penguins 0-3 on the power play. We'll try to break the ice here. It's 3-3. Boy, would this be a huge goal going to the locker room. Goligoski to Malkin. Malkin trying to recover the puck now, battling. Hall wheeled it to the line. Good play by Letang to keep it in. Now to Sidney Crosby up high. Crosby right to Goligoski. Boy, put him in a tough spot there. Adam Hall after the puck. Letang trying to lift his stick, but he's able to dump it down the ice. Down to 26 seconds to go in the period.
Penguins trying to use that whole offensive zone, if they can, to lure the Lightning out high.
Letang takes the pass, a bouncing puck, gloved down by Malkin, a man open on the left side. And nothing happens as the Lightning are able to knock it back up into the Penguins zone. 8 seconds to go in the period.
One last opportunity, possibly.
Legoski will just shoot it long on Ellis. And the Penguins will have a minute 40, I believe it is, to work with. They took it off the board just as I was looking at it. We'll look at the other board. What is it, Bob?
Puck 04, it looks like.
Yeah, minute 4. They took it off the board just as the period came to an end. Can you give us a second to see what...
No, they're going to show you the shots. And the shots say 21-19 here. That matches what the boys in the Trek have, or Fort Pitt Capital by the numbers. Tampa Bay has one power play goal. The Penguins have two shorthanded goals. It's 3-3, and Fleury has made tremendous stops here, including a penalty shot against Bergenheim.
Yep, that was Fleury's period for sure.
Live on ESPN America, home of the NHL.
Dupuis got a pair of penalties. Penguins have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 minors. Pascal Dupuis had minor penalties in the last 3 games. First time that that's happened since back in 2009, in January of that year. And it worked out okay.
Penguins with 22 shots, the Bolts with 19. The Lightning of a team that averaging 36 shots a game. So the Penguins would love to that shot total down here in the third period and establish that offensive zone time and retake the lead if they can. Here's Goligoski now. They'll drop it back to Sidney Crosby. We have 50 seconds remaining on this power play. This is a huge opportunity for the Penguins to get a leg up here early in the third period. Letang on the ice for the Penguins. Sends it down the wall to Malkin. Pass too fast, and he hurried it over there for Goligoski, who has to retreat to his own line.
Hall of Famer Phil Esposito was just oozing and beaming, telling us about how what he thought of Chris Letang's game. He said, wow, what a fantastic player you got out there in Letang. He's just a superstar in between the second and third here.
Here's Evgeny Malkin with a down low to Sid. Back up top for Chris Letang. Letang shuffles it along for Malkin. Kunitz is in front of the net. Malkin just dumps it to the far near wall and is taken out by Brett Clark. He sees a Penguin behind the net in Malkin, and then turns and centers it for his defenseman, Hedman, who lost control of it. It comes out to Letang. Letang, quick shot, and Crosby got the pull the trigger there. The save was made. Letang with a rebound, and he guns it wide of the goal. The penalty's over. Ellis made a good save again on Sid, it appeared there, as the puck is cleared down the ice. And Letang going back to get it. And it is another penalty. A slashing call coming up here against the Penguins.
Yes, it is. Another minor here. Letang was doing a little drifting, that hovercraft move there as he's able to go back and create space to make that play to Sidney Crosby and get an opportunity. And then Kunitz over on the wall tries to lay a body blow. There it is. See the slash on the stick. That overhand tomahawk kind of motion there. That axe motion. When you come from the top, up high, down low, you're going to get called for that every time.
Penguins win the draw. Orpik in front of his own net. Couldn't get it out, though. And now he'll get another crack at it and knock it back up into the Lightning zone. Oh, boy. These special teams and goaltending. And of course, as we said, the special teams have been a big factor in the Lightning's good start. They allowed 2 shorthanded goals tonight. Still looking for a power play. They did get the 5-on-3 power play goal, but not a 5-on-4 yet. Cavalier scoring with a two-man advantage. Cavalier with a puck now in the corner. Malone. Orpik took a stick in the face and he goes down. Nobody saw it. Orpik still down. Play continues. Centering pass by Saint-Louis was cut off by the goaltender Fleury. Orpik up on his skates right now. Cook has no stick as the puck shot wide of the net. Saint-Louis takes it. Well, they blew the whistle earlier for Lundin, but not for Orpik in this situation. Saint-Louis with a shot. The save made by Fleury. But Cavalier takes the rebound. Moves it out to Saint-Louis. Orpik just battling in front of the net right now. Another shot down low by LeCavalier. Stopped by Fleury. The Penguins need to get control of the puck here and get it out and help Brooks Orpik if they can. But there's LeCavalier with it again. Now for Saint-Louis. 53 seconds to go on the penalty. Great puck control by the Lightning here on this power play. And the Penguins got to be getting tired. Matt Cook, no stick. Saint-Louis with it. And Saint-Louis will bring it right to the feet of Cook. He can pass it right by Cook. And he did, and Stamkos missed the net. He's not been able to get himself in a good shooting position, Stamkos. He's kind of awkward when he's been getting the puck. That's what the Penguins want. Orpik still out here, touches the puck.
And he is spitting blood right now on the ice because he took an elbow, spitting something right in the lip. You could see him uncomfortable. Take a look at the elbow. Right there, the right elbow as Malone moves around. Intentional or not, those elbow pads are rather hard. They, you know, they've changed the ruling and the padding on those elbow pads to make them less rigid. But right there, that doesn't feel good, Staggy. And Malone is a big man. That was a Gordie Howe elbow.
Letang one-timer sails wide of the goal. 25 seconds to go on the penalty to Chris Kunitz. Here's Dupuis to the puck. Talbot. Talbot gets upended. Looked like he may have drawn a penalty there, but nothing called. And now Saint-Louis has it. And Marty Saint-Louis carries the puck right up the alley. He's to the right wing for Downey. Legoski on him. Downey keeps on moving, though. Banks it off the boards. Saint-Louis behind the net with Downey teaming up. And over to Purcell. And Purcell trying to generate offense from behind the net. Kunitz is on the ice, so the Penguins are back at full strength. Purcell's shot to the equipment of Fleury, and he'll freeze it for a face-off in the Penguins zone. So the Penguins kill that Lightning power play, but it really was kind of tough sledding there for a while as they were stuck in their own zone for almost the entire power play.
Well, the Lightning, they have the talent out there, and they're really going to the front of the net, trying to make it real hard for that man, number 29, Marc-Andre Fleury. Make him move. Make him make save after save. They get a lot of bodies in front of the flower right now.
Bergenheim with it again to the front of the net. And he just tried to go right over Fleury and into the goal. Fleury's down right now. I didn't know where the puck was. It was on the opposite side from where he was in the net. Fortunately, the Lightning didn't get to it. Lundin with a blast. That's off a stick wide of the goal. Bergenheim to the puck again. And it's following the Lightning right now here in the third period. Bergenheim with it again. Downey goes behind the net. Sean Bergenheim sends it back around to the far side where it's taken by Matthias Olin. And he hammers one off the end boards around to the near side where Lundin backhands it right back down the wall. The Penguins trying to get possession here and get out of their own zone. They don't like to spend a lot of time in their own end, I'll tell you that.
Nope. Another good play by the Flowers. Bergenheim put that puck right to the net. Just bowled him right over. Bergenheim skates like Alexei Morozov a little bit. He's got that kind of talent starting to show a little bit for Tampa in Tampa Bay here.
Derek Englund knocks it inside the line. After it, but it's taken by Tyrell down the wall. He's hit hard by Englund on the far board. Makes him pay the price. Then Adam Holgorsen wins the battle for the puck against Goligoski. Walks out again. This is what they try to do. Just barge their way to the front of the net. And Englund says, no, Adam, that's as far as you're going.
I love that. You know, Englund over on the far wall, closing in on his man. You want to mess with me? You want to mess with my goalie? Bergenheim went right into the goaltender. Watch this. He's going to bowl him over. Downey's going to get a wide open net here and just can't corral the puck. Hits the side of the net. Flower has no idea where it is. And then Adam Hall scored in this fashion the other game against Nashville. Tampa's last game tried to curl it around. Ex-Penguin Adam Hall. Been a good opportunity here in Tampa Bay after Steve Yzerman, who was with the Wings when the Penguins won their Stanley Cup, appreciated what Adam Hall brought to the Penguins lineup when he was here.
Cavalier after the puck. Clear to the far boards. Stays with the Lightning, though, as it's dumped in by Randy Jones to LeCavalier in his backhand. Back up top to Jones. Listen to the corner. Comrie is there. And sent it up the wall. Otesta was tied up by Randy Jones. Neither one of them could play the puck as it came through. And Kubina dumps it right back into the Penguin zone.
Maybe Malkin can catch on fire. Hasn't scored in the third period of the last 13 Penguin regular season games. So maybe he's the man.
Otesta over the line. But Comrie a step ahead of the play on the left wing. And offside. We'll take a look at our Aspen Dental plays that made you smile.
Well, yeah, two shorthanded goals on one penalty. Dupuis in the box. There's one and there's two as Cook picks the corner. And back in that April 11th game, 2009, when the Penguins scored two shorthanded goals, they indeed come on, they came on the same penalty when they had the two shorthanded goals back in 2009.
Werfel back to play the puck for Letang, and he's hit by Hall. Purcell, Thompson centered for Hall, and Fleury flopping to the ice, got to the puck before Adam Hall did.
You see, these guys, they play the same game, right? They know what they're doing, and their game is 5 feet in front of the goal line and in behind the net, and they're just going to throw everything in the net, everything to the foot of the goaltender, and the minutes of these guys goes up, and now for the first time, St. Louis not playing 24, 25 minutes a game. LeCavier's not playing 24, 25 minutes a game. Their minutes are down to 21, more reasonable because of what these guys are doing. They don't even have Dominic Moore in the lineup tonight, nor Simone Gagné, who's injured.
Reminiscent, really, of the Penguins' third line, the way it works with the Stahl, Kennedy, and Cook. They get the puck deep and keep it down low.
Yep.
And now it's Chris Letang stepping ahead, and he'll rifle it up into the Lightning zone, held up there by Ellis, taken by Hedman. 6'6", Hedman comes to center, moves it to the left wing for Nate Thompson. It's at the end of his shift. He dumps the puck in. Fleury holds it up for Brooks Orpik. 13:53 to go in the third period. This game is tied at 3. Fans coming to life here. Good crowd tonight in Tampa, and they need more of those. There's a giveaway, and look out, it's Bergenheim coming back again. He shoots it right to the chest of Fleury, who holds on. And we'll take a break.
We told you earlier that Guy Boucher is the youngest coach in the National Hockey League, but he's not the youngest man to ever get behind the bench as a head coach. That goes to Gary Green, who was 26 when he did it. And if that name Lionel Conacher stands out, it should, because before he was a player head coach with the New York Americans, he played for the Pittsburgh Pirates of the National Hockey League, guys.
And Guy Boucher, shot to the goal, is blocked. Penguin's able to work at the center. Said that Jean Pronovost, the former Penguin, is like a second dad to him. Here's Tyler Kennedy down the wing. He coached him at McGill. Here's St. Louis back. Look out, Lovejoy trying to catch him to the goal. He scores! A great individual effort by Marty St. Louis. Fleury tried the poke check, but he drilled it in behind him.
Did anybody know that this 35-year-old has got the same kind of speed as when he broke into the National Hockey League with the Calgary Flames? Wow. Lovejoy tried to go around, and when the poke check came out, St. Louis felt it just at the last second and was able to chip it up over the stick of Marc-Andre Fleury and right in the top corner. And yeah, you got to get excited about that one if you're Martin St. Louis. A spectacular goal, a speedy goal.
When we talked the other night when we were in St. Louis about guys who can skate at top speed with the puck on their stick.
Well, he just caught Lovejoy flat-footed. I mean, Lovejoy looked like he was turning, but when he turned, Martin St. Louis turned it up another speed, another gear. And not a lot of players have that extra gear. In St. Louis,
he still does have it at 35, and he stuck out that huge
left
short
leg,
but big left leg.
Yeah, well, they are. They're like
he's got the big legs. I know. His legs are. It's absurd how big they are for a little man.
He weighs 180 pounds each leg. Well, Fleury couldn't play it. No play zone that puck, and there's another chance.
No, Bergenheim couldn't turn it to the backhand. And the Penguins are on the ropes right now. They've been turning the puck over. They're not getting it deep. They've established no zone time in the third. There's a shot stop. Randy Jones let it go. Fleury made the save. The Penguins need to give the Lightning a dose of their own medicine and get the puck deep and go to work. That's why they've got Rupp and Asham on the ice right now. Asham goes in, gets a hit on the defenseman, Olin. Now following on is Letestu to try to get to it, but the Lightning able to move it back to center. Taken by Goligoski. So Downey and Stamkos assist at 6:40 on the fourth goal of the season for Marty St. Louis, who's put up big numbers in his career. career against Pittsburgh, and as in games that we've been down here, he has often been the man who has lifted the spirits of his teammates and obviously the fans here in the building. And that was a great example of that. Just a tremendous individual play by Marty St. Louis.
Well, this wasn't a game. This was all Pittsburgh until they made the goaltender change. Guy Boucher makes the goaltender change at 3-1. All of a sudden, Tampa's got some light here.
Well, Legoski tried to feed it through. Couldn't get it through. The Lightning doing a better job of defensive zone coverage. Now to Lovejoy, a shot and a save. Rebound, Malkin. An opportunity. It was blocked. Somebody got a stick in there just as he was ready to fire for the empty net.
Yeah, you know, it was a little close to his feet. You go, look, there's a penalty. Adam Hall shuffled the stick that was on the ice towards the Penguins. He's going to be penalized. Adam Hall is for shuffling that stick that was on the ice towards the puck that was being carried by Alex Goligoski. Malkin was jammed the play before. The puck came out to his feet. He just couldn't get his stick there towards his feet and kind of corral it into that wide open net.
Another example of Engelin getting the puck to the net quickly.
Tampa, here it is. Watch how this puck comes out close to his feet. He just can't get a stick in there. Just to move it. And there's a stick from Thompson behind that didn't help either. There's the stick. Watch Hall shuffles the stick towards the puck. You can't do that. It's a penalty. The Penguins with a great opportunity to tie it up here. 11:26 in the third. And this game has had a little of everything in it.
And the Penguins with a man advantage are 0-for-4. They've got 6 shots on their 4 power play opportunities. And you talk about timeliness. They need one right here. Malkin's backhander doesn't go through. So Tang will take it. St. Louis pressuring up top, and he's a danger. Look at that. They got St. Louis and Stamkos killing the penalty. You saw the Penguins generate offense earlier shorthanded. Shot by Crosby right through traffic past Kunitson, wide of the goal. Malkin takes it in the corner. Kunitz is open, and he centered it. And I think Ellis got a piece of that with his right pad. Crosby with it again. Looks for Goligoski. Back to Sid. Letang's open, but he's going to have to hunt the puck to the far side. A diving play against St. Louis, and Letang won the battle to force it to the corner. But St. Louis back behind the net for Lundin. Crosby takes a look over the right shoulder, gets to the puck, moves it along for Malkin. Now to Letang. Still, it's Stamkos and St. Louis up top on the penalty kill. Lundin and Kubina are back. Letang centers it again right through the goal now to the near side. Crosby pokes it to the corner. Letang takes it there, centers it, hits St. Louis, held in by Malkin. And he didn't get enough on it to force it to either Crosby or Letang. Not sure he was going to there. Now Fleury hurries the play along as the Lightning finally are able to change their penalty killers. 54 seconds to go on the penalty. Goligoski with it. Trying to get it to Crosby. Good play to chop it over to Letang. Chris holds it, centers. It goes past Sid to Malkin. Kunitz is in front of the net. Here's Goligoski with it. To Letang. He sets it up and tried to anyway for a redirect or a shot pass in front, and it's broken up by the Lightning and cleared. Well, they make another quick change on their penalty killing unit.
Yeah, they do, and you get St. Louis and Stamkos out there. The Penguins, you got to respect that. They've already got a ton of shorthanded chances, as have the Penguins. They've converted 2 of theirs. They're deadly.
Now they're in the last 23 seconds of this power play, and Ryan Malone's on the ice as a penalty killer for the Lightning. There's a good hustling play by Tyler Kennedy to keep it in. Remember that, as Ruff gives it to Kennedy, a shot, and then Ellis makes the save, and there's no rebound available for Matt Cook, who was providing a screen in front.
Well, you know, without the services of Dominic Moore, he'd be killing penalties, and now they're up 4-3 in a hockey game, and you only have 10 minutes left. So what do you say? You say, I'm going to play my best players, as long as they know how to kill penalties. And it was all pressure, wasn't it? You talk about speed. St. Louis, you saw his speed on the goal. Stamkos got speed. It was all pressure there, forcing the Penguins' hand. They don't want them to set up, because when the Penguins set up, that's when they become very deadly.
Now Rupp takes a faceoff, smashes it to the net. And a stick save made by Ellis. Now Downey gave it away. And the pass intended for Letestu finally gets to him. Cook trying to get to the puck, but it's chopped away, and here comes Adam Hall out of the box, and he was looking for the puck there. Martin goes back to touch up, and it's an icing call against Tampa Bay. FSN, that's a big game, and now off the draw, taken by Brooks Orpik. Asham centers off a stick.
This is a bigger game right here.
And it goes back now for Orpik. Yeah, this is a very interesting game. The Penguins are down by 1, a little over halfway through the third period. Comrie ahead, off a stick. Talbot tried to get to it. And up the wall it comes for Vincent LeCavalier. Ahead for Downey, and he'll hunt the puck in behind the net. Fleury, though, steps out, sends it around. Martin couldn't play it. LeCavalier kept on going. Now there they are behind the net again. They've done a good job of making plays from back there, just as Dan Bylsma promised us they would. Now Brett Clark runs into traffic. Comrie was upended as those two collided at the blue line. An offside is called against Tampa Bay. We will be back in a moment. Tonight's top protection defensive play of the game is brought to you by Degree for Men. It won't let you down.
Yeah. Well, look at that protection there. The glove with a big save. Once again, the glove on the penalty shot by Bergenheim. The game has changed here. It's 4-3 Tampa. The Penguins, you know, they get a little frustrated and not patient enough with that 1-3-1 in the neutral zone. They turned a couple of pucks over here. You really just have to go about your business in a 3-3 game. Get the puck deep. Now it's 4-3 Tampa. And I think, you know, that's the kind of games. Tampa's going to win a lot of these hockey games. The teams are just unaware and just won't stick to getting pucks deep. You have against a 1-3-1, it's tough to get through that by skating it.
Nate Thompson centers one to Adam Hall, and it's broken up at the last second. These guys have been a force tonight. They had a good shift towards the end of the game against Nashville the other night to get a goal and made it 4-2. They were down 4-1 in the game. They gave their team a little life. And they've been good right from the start of this hockey game, scoring on the first shot of the game. Now it's Victor Hedman moving it ahead. Hall banks it off the boards and back down to Chris Letang skating back in front of his own net. Good play by Letang, but then he just gives it away as he dumps it the length of the ice, going back to get it as Randy Jones. Ellis came out to move it up the wall for Adam Hall. Aaron Asham plows into him and finishes his check against Randy Jones, and the Lightning able to work that puck back to center. It's Purcell with it in over the line. Purcell centers one right through the goal mouth, and Aaron Asham hustles to the puck, moves it onto the stick of Letestu, but it's rolled off his stick. And look out, one man back for the Penguins is Martin. Lecavalier closes in to Purcell, and Martin went down to the ice to block the shot by Teddy Purcell. And now the Penguins come storming back. It's Aaron Asham with it, dropping it off for Mark Letestu. He centers one. Cleared away by Pavel Kabina to the corner.
Well, it reminds you of what the other number seven used to do. Mark Eaton blocked so many of those chances in front. And a great play by the new number seven, Martin. What a play that was defensively.
Another example of England just getting pucks to the net. Why can't even the most talented guys don't do that as much as he does? He does a great job of it. Just gets the puck to the goal, and he seems to get his shots on the net, forcing Ellis to make a save there and stop play. And there's the play.
Yeah, I'm not sure what, if
by Mark
hit it or not.
Certainly looked like it on the first chance, but maybe not.
Maybe not. But he was there, though, and he played that two-on-one perfectly. He went at the man, then he backed off, so there was no backdoor pass. That was a perfect tap-in. He created indecision is what he did for the two-on-one.
Matt Cook got a stick on that to direct it up into the Lightning zone. Jones going back to play it up high off the glass. Tyler Kennedy couldn't play it, and the Lightning able to work it back to the Penguin line. Now the clock is the enemy of the Penguins. Down to 6:35 in its game, down by one.
Three of the first nine here have gone to overtime for the Penguins so far this year.
Penguins had six shots in the third period.
Only takes one.
Talbot, and he dumps it softly behind the defense.
That's it. That's the play. And then the hit, and then the bang. And then you need another man over there getting the puck. Talbot interfered with.
Yeah.
Talbot trying to get over to the wall.
And he ran over Tyrell. Now Nate Thompson, his pocket picked by his counterpart, number 44, Brooks Orpik. So Thompson knocks it away from him. Flurry over to Letang. Look at Thompson. He's just a demon right now for the line. This line's really doing their thing now because they just want to keep the puck at the other end of the rink and kill the clock. They've got enough goals to win. Crosby runs over Brett Clark. Sidney has a couple of shots, three shots blocked, nine faceoff wins, 10 losses in the circle in this game. Works the corner. Centering pass now. Martin to Goligoski. Back to Paul Martin, who just dumps it to the corner. Adams in after Trevino all over him. Crosby in there as well.
Tampa with three blue jerseys against two white jerseys. Crosby held up there. The Hedman.
This is a game where I think this is the first time where I've really felt in a game that Jordan Staal would come in mighty handy. In this game, and he's not there, but I have a feeling he might be in the lineup Friday night when the Penguins play the Flyers. He's that close.
Yeah, he is that close. And there's a big hit by Crosby. Crosby had words with Hedman as those two superstars, well, one at a really different level, another trying to get to that level.
Paul Martin trying to get that puck away from St. Louis, just dogging him all the way back into the Penguins zone, and an offside play brings another whistle. Well, the Lightning are playing like a team that's very hungry for a win here on their home ice. They lead it by one.
There it is, our Subway sandwich of the game. Watch the leg drive from the low up. Watch them drive up. There it is.
Now you want to use the legs to hit, and that's going backwards and sideways by a defenseman. You got to be a good skater. You got to be a good skater as well.
That's a big man he knocked backwards.
It is. Adam Hall has been noticeable tonight.
6'3", 213. Oh, yeah, his line's been really good. They've done their job, and now they kind of have a perfect role right now. Their team leading by one. The Penguins have to just find a way to work for that tying goal. You've got to find a way to do it.
You got to draw a penalty. Maybe you got to come with speed through that 1-3-1 configuration. Here they come right now. Maybe draw a penalty. There's the chip. You got to get the man there quick, though.
Well, that's the problem. The other one is that defenseman. He's all the way back in his own zone.
But they didn't hit him. They had a chance to hit him there. Malkin turned away from him. And the first guy has to plaster him. Second guy get the puck. First guy plaster. Second guy puck. The Penguins are changing defense, so they can't keep that puck in.
And it's hard to hit him when he's back there. He's got a 30-foot lead on you going back for the puck into his own zone. By the time you get to him, the puck got way, way gone. And that's the beauty of having that guy sitting back there. Now Kennedy just pushes it down the line, and there's Hedman lifting it back out to center.
On the speed.
Quick shot by Hall, and Fleury stops play.
See what Adam Hall did there? He wasn't even trying to score. His objective was to get it there, and as he was shooting it, he was skating to the net. And so were his line mates, because they're on the same page. Look, watch all the Lightning players. Get the line just onside. And look, they're all just going to go to the net, because they know Adam Hall's not going to drop past it. He's not going to look for a pass. He's not going to put it anywhere but on the net. And if he doesn't put it on the net, he won't play. That's the way it works here in Tampa these days with Steve Yzerman, with Guy Boucher.
Lightning have beaten some pretty good teams already this year. Philadelphia, Dallas, Montreal. There's a chance. Oh, right at the side of the net. And it was there again. Marty St. Louis trying to put the icing on the cake. Well, the Penguins come back, and it's Mike Rupp dubbing into the corner. Now you can get a hit on a guy. Lundin is hit by Aaron Asham.
Yep,
one guy. They go to work in the corner. Lundin was down. He gets back up. Another man's down on his all fours right now. That was Kubina. Orpik back to the front of the net. Asham's trying to get to it. Kwan and pawn away at one of the Lightning players as he came to center ice. Steven Stamkos was on the ice. Oh, Ruff got hit hard. He might have hurt his shoulder a little bit there as he collided with Pavel Kubina. Appears to be all right. As the puck comes back to the Penguin net, we're down to 2:50 to go in this game. It's the Lightning 4 and the Penguins 3.
The Penguins also have the defenseman that can carry the puck through this. Quite honestly, it won't work. You know, the Penguins, if they bring speed from their blue line, and the likes of Goligoski, Letang, or Martin, they can skate right through this thing, but they got to come with speed.
That's the one benefit of having those kind of D on your team. There's a shot by Letang, and it's blocked. Sails up into the netting, and there was Adam Hall again right in front of Chris Letang blocking the shot.
And sometimes that player, like we've seen Letang do many a times, is you get as far as you can go, then you dump it in. You know where you're dumping it in more than anybody. Dump it into that area, then go get it. You have the green light, especially with 2:24, but at any time of the game, you have the green light to go chase that puck down.
Sidney Crosby will take the faceoff. Sid has an assist tonight. He wins the draw nicely. Letang fires high and wide. The rebound off the end boards. Ellis was there. And a good chance for Malkin, but he couldn't finish the play. And now Kunitz throws it back in front for Sid. Poked away by Ellis. Hedman sending around the boards, taken there by Paul Martin, who backhands it back down for Malkin. He keeps it moving along the boards. Victor Hedman there. Kunitz plows into him. Nate Thompson tried to move it along to Hall. It got through to him, and he backs it off the boards. Here comes Tyrell. Letang. Plays tough on him, and Fleury moves the puck along for Martin. Look out, he runs into Ryan Malone. And then the puck is dumped to the corner. Kubina goes back for it. Dupuis hustling in. Finishes off his man. And the Penguins now get possession on the wall. Letestu has the puck, centers it. Bouncing puck to the corner. Brooks Orpik takes it. A minute 41 to go in this game. Brooks Orpik in deep on the play. As a man open at the point, it's Goligoski. His shot, Fleury. Save made by Ellis.
And Pascal Dupuis mad at himself because he didn't get in the lane of the goaltender. He got boxed out. He went to the other side of the defenseman. That's why Ellis is able to make this save with the glove. Pascal Dupuis wants to get in the shooting lane. Goligoski's looking for him to get in the shooting lane, but he's just off to the goaltender, off to the side. Watch. He's in front now, but then he gets just to the side. Goaltender can see it. If he's right in front, then the goaltender's vision is impeded.
Timeout here.
The Penguins have called their timeout, and there's Ellis.
Is it a Penguin timeout for sure?
Yeah, okay.
Well, let's take a look at the difference in the hockey game. At 3-3, Martin St. Louis picked up ahead of steam and through the neutral zone was able to take a pass and walk around. Then Lovejoy put it up over the poke-checking stick of Marc-Andre Fleury. And that's so far the deciding goal.
There are a lot of game breakers in this game, and St. Louis is certainly one of them. He did win the Hart Trophy in 04 with 94 points, and that's the same total he had last year. He had more goals the year he won the Hart. He had 38. He had 29 last year for the Lightning. Still doing it. That's a great plays.
Yep. 94.
At the age of 35.
94 points. Dan Ellis has faced 23 shots. Hasn't allowed a goal in the empty net here.
Yep. The Penguins have the extra attacker on. They've set it up on the bench with their timeout, and Letang has the puck. He finds Letestu, who turns and whips it off the end board. But Crosby will get to it out to Goligoski. Down the wall for Sid. Nice pass to Letestu. Quick shot. That hit Kunitz in front and ricocheting to the corner. Now still up for grabs on the wall. Who's going to win this battle? Kunitz comes up with it behind the net for Malkin. Malkin with Brett Clark guarding him. Minute four to go. Empty net down to our right. That one's with good puck control. Goligoski to Letang. His shot. Never got through. Brett Clark up the wall for St. Louis. He'll chip it ahead. Adam Hall can't catch up with it. Goligoski goes to get it. The Lightning make a wholesale change here to try to defend against this Penguin team. Trying to tie it with an extra man on the ice. Letang racing to the corner. Kubina in after it. Letang runs him in to the boards. And Altoona centers one. There's nobody there. Look at Letang. All over the ice. Letang getting to the puck again. But this time Stamkos had it on the stick. Now to St. Louis. Here he goes to the open net. He's hooked all the way, but he scores.
Chris Letang ran over Pavel Kabina. He's taking exception now. There's the blood from the elbow Malone on the jersey of Brooks Orpik. There's Marc-Andre Fleury, who's stuck at 149 wins. And there's Martin St. Louis, whose speed, once again, is very evident.
Not to mention his desire to get to that net with Goligoski hooking him all the way.
And once he hooked him and he was clear, it was an automatic goal because of the empty net. But it seemed like Chris Letang was the first man on the puck on one side, the first man on the puck on the other side. The Penguins had 6-5. They just couldn't get it done. And Dan Ellis, the stopgap coming in relief of Mike Smith, is going to get a victory here tonight.
Well, we talked about the marquee matchup of Crosby and Stamkos and all the big names. We did show you the undrafted player. Dupuy with a shot. Ellis the save. Rebound wrapped around in front and Ellis freezes it. We showed you all the names of top players picked in the draft. And then we showed you Marty St. Louis, who was never drafted. And we showed it for a reason, because we know that he always plays very good games against Pittsburgh, and he rises to the occasion. It's definitely showtime for all these players. And this guy stole the show tonight in the third period.
Yeah, and I don't think anybody, you're not surprised when Marty St. Louis does that kind of thing. I mean, he doesn't care that he used the fact that he wasn't drafted to his advantage. You tell me I can't play?
And yet there was a team that had him, Calgary, and let him go.
Yep.
Now taken by Matthias Olund with 16 seconds remaining in this hockey game. The Lightning are going to move into the top spot. Seconds to go. Tampa Bay will have 13 points in the standings. A conversation here with 1 second to go. They run the time off the clock and it's over. So the Lightning move into the top spot of the Eastern Conference, raising their record to 6-2-1. And our McDonald's player of the game is little Marty St. Louis. 2 goals and an assist, 9 shots in the hockey game, including the game winner and the icing on the cake, the empty netter here tonight.
Yeah, you said the word, desire. We heard Boucher talk about the desire and
the will to compete about Sidney Crosby and his game, and he's got a guy just like that on the other side in Martin St. Louis that really keeps this motor running here in Tampa.
Penguins record drops to 5-4-1, and their next game is Friday against the Philadelphia Flyers on home ice. Anticipating the possible return of Jordan Staal, the Lightning salute the crowd here. Our coverage for that game starts at 6 on Friday night. The Starkist Penguins postgame with Rob King and Jay Caulfield is coming up next. For Bob Airy, Dan Potash, and our crew here in Tampa Bay, this is Paul Steigerwald. Good night, everybody. Final score, Tampa 5 and the Penguins 3.
ESPN America, your home for the NHL.